Activity 17 is about applying this principle of ovals. So let's look at this now in the arrangement that the workbook asks you to do. It asks you to collect together some objects around your own environment, perhaps in the home. It might be some tins. We can add together a few of these tins standing upright. That's fairly easy to do. We have a major axis, we have the two minor axes, and those two minor axes are actually one continuous line through the whole object. And it's that rule which enables us to construct the objects lying on their side, the cylinders lying on their side. We need to put in that axis line through here. I need to put in those two major axes at 90 degrees to it. And then I use those to help me construct the two ellipses that are going to be the top and bottom of the tin which is supposed to be lying on its side. So you can see here now we've got three cylinders, and to increase that effect, I'm just going to put in some lines which hopefully will allow you to see that as the internal shape, and then this one as the exterior shape. I'm going to turn this around just while I draw these lines, because I want to get them quite accurate onto there, and the same for that one. So we've got a sketch now of a selection of three objects, some cylinders standing vertically, some lying on their sides, but they all follow that same rule of major axes, minor axes, central axes, which help us to construct a plausible representation of our collection of objects.